on the gridiron, but there's no doubt who the big red machine is on Monday Night Raw. But can he win the Intercontinental title?
Sign this all-important matchup. Who will meet the world's heavyweight champion Sunday, October the 20th at No Mercy in the All-Tel Arena?
Well, you got to admit, Triple H was dominant tonight. What did he say, Art? Go ahead and say it. He was.
Well, I
dominant.
I think he was very impressive. Dominant may not be the word. He certainly was seemingly dependent on Rick Flair's assistance. And look at the power of Kane. Jericho locking up that collar and elbow. Oh, hard right hand.
What about that? Speaking of dominant, what about that Trish matchup? I mean, that was really something. And then Victoria, she lost it with that chair.
And I have known women in my life like that, Victoria. But not that big and not that powerful.
You married some of them. Oh, look at
that's another issue. And look at Kane with all that power. Kane is. I think he's quicker, and he's got a quicker first step than he's ever had here in the here on Raw.
Let me ask you this, JR. Who do you think Triple H would rather face?
Well, hell, Jericho.
Huh? Why is that? Jericho was the first ever undisputed WWE champion.
And he was the man that Triple H beat at WrestleMania.
And he's a huge rock star.
Well, that's Jericho's song, and he's, I guess, still singing it. I don't know. Oh, nibble uppercut by Kane. Great. Why in God's name would any sane human being
kiss Kane?
Want to step in the ring with Kane?
I'm going to have a long talk with Terry.
With the winner take all man. Does she still call you Uncle Jerry?
Now, wait a minute. What? Uh-oh.
Look at this. Yeah, we need him out here like we need a boy.
Look at a boy. Now look at Kane. Well, don't get excited, Kane.
Boom! Boom!
Middle-aged and crazy.
Yeah. You think he's riding in style. He's styling and profiling.
I've heard that for 30 years.
Yeah, oh, baby, wait a minute. He jumped up there. He may be on the bed. Look at some champagne.
Look at this. Jericho's beat on the rope.
Got him.
Jericho, take this thing any way he can get it. Any way. Count out, disqualification, cheat. It don't matter to Jericho. He just wants to get out of Houston, Texas with his Intercontinental title. That's all that matters to the rock star.
Well, let me just say this, JR. I'm beginning to think, now, you can't. You don't think that Kane really has a chance in this match, do you? Granted, he won the tag team title last week, but he don't have a chance in this match. You don't think that, do you?
Well, you damn right I think.
Oh, come on, JR. There you go.
Hey,
I mean, Kane's a freak.
This ain't gonna be no upset. If Kane leaves here tonight with the Intercontinental title, the tilt-a-whirl, the slam, the gut. Wait a minute.
Like, put on the ropes. Put on the ropes, Earl.
Bert put the foot onto the rope. I guess that Jericho, when they had the little huddle, Jericho and Flair.
Now, wait a minute.
Triple H worked out a little plan.
Wait a minute. Don't do this, Kane. Don't lose your cool here. You got a big chance to win this.
Kane,
his title.
Don't get counted out like the Big Show did earlier. And look at Flair. Gucci loafers and Rolex watches and just distracted at this God dang it. That's what Jericho set up. That's all
he should wear. A cowboy hat and Levi's.
I don't give a damn what he wears. I don't know. And I don't care. He wear what he wants. He has no business being out here. That's what I was trying to get to. He's already been involved. Chop that mug by Kane. Knocking down Y2J. Flair living vicariously through Triple H. If you ask me, everybody did. I volunteered it.
You know what? There's not a prayer for Kane to win this thing.
Will you look at that? To the floor.
That should be a disqualification.
Well,
he should just be disqualified for that. That was blatant disregard for a man's.
Get out! I think it's.
He can't do that. He can't.
The hell he can't.
This ain't baseball. You can't have ejection.
And Kane, the right hand. Flair's been ejected. And Kane just beating the hell out of the Nature Boy.
Good grief.
Flair knocked down and still rampway. And the hell is breaking loose here. Jericho's down. Flair is down. Kane has beat the hell out of him. We've got to take our last break. We've got to take our last break. Stop now. Look at this. Kane's still dominating Jericho. Welcome back, everybody.
You're right, Jer. We are back. We don't take no halftime. This ain't football. These guys didn't even take a break. They've been pounding each other's brains out.
Well, the referee finally got Ric Flair the hell out of here. The Intercontinental title on the line. This is a four-week break. Look at that Gorilla Slam by Kane.
This is some of the action that took place during the break. I mean, these guys did not stop. Oh,
no doubt in my mind that Triple H and Flair, Jericho had this whole thing clear. That's why Flair came out. Oh, look at that. Kane going up top. Jericho saw it. Shoved the referee, which could have been a disqualification, into the rope.
Whoa! I told you Kane had no chance. Look at that. Did you see that move? Chris Jericho is a huge rock star, and he's a fantastic wrestler.
This ain't no rock concert.
Great champion.
Well, he is a hell of a champion. He's a hell of a wrestler. There's no doubt about it. And Jericho trying to go for a super hit here. If he hits this,
this is going to be phenomenal.
The winner of this match will meet the World Heavyweight Champion.
He got it.
And no mercy for the Intercontinental title. What a superplex. What a superplex. And the world's title will be combined. Winner take all.
Thinking of combined, what about over 300 pounds of Kane just got combined with a ring mat? Slammed into that floor.
Okay, what about next week? We're going to be live in Las Vegas, Thomas and Mack Center. Every match determined by the spin of the wheel. Raw roulette. The cover by Jericho. And no, it's not over. Wow. It's damn sure not over. The big red machine reaching down and sucking it up. Powered out of that lava press. Kane knows what's on the line here.
He is up to his feet. I can't believe it. Look out, Chris.
Jericho's got to be wondering, what in the hell do I have to do to beat this freak of nature?
He'll find something. He's resourceful. Look at this. He's got it. Don't have him.
And there he goes with that shoulder whirl again. Just sternum first and a nice drop kick right into the knee. That's a smart move by Jericho.
Yes, it is.
He got the vertical base of his bigger, taller, more powerful opponent by working on those legs.
You know what? I'm going to tell you something. I disagree with Kane. Totally disagree with you. You know what I disagree with, JR?
Well, what would that be? What?
Matt. What he said about the chicks digging masks.
Are you having a damn senior moment? Where are you going with that? Look at Jericho, we're off the apron. And Kane, that knee, just buried into the steel steps. Jericho will be very happy to win this match by count out.
But you know what chicks do dig?
What?
Huge rock stars.
Me.
They dig huge rock stars like Chris Jericho.
Why don't you join his band and play the spoons or something? God's sakes.
The spoons?
Jericho shoving Kane back inside. Good Lord.
Are you Ted Mack?
This sounds like the amateur hour, isn't it? Chicks digging mask. Look at Jericho.
Well,
he's driving that
don't.
Elbow right in the thigh, the knee of Kane. Spinning toe hold. Engage to the punch.
Look at Kane. He's having to resort to trying to.
Jericho loved for Kane to tap out. Jericho loved to win by count out or disqualification. He doesn't care. If Jericho wants to get to Little Rock, Arkansas, and no mercy, Sunday, October the 20th, and meet the world's champion in a winner-take-all match. And Kane, with a one good leg, just shoved Jericho shoulder first to the steel, to the floor.
And do you know what that match is going to mean, JR? It is unprecedented. Eric Bischoff, our illustrious leader, said it right. I mean, that's, oh, it's trend-setting. It's unbelievable. One show, one champion.
Next thing you know, Bischoff will be the CEO of Tyco. Look at this. Again, Jericho focusing on those legs of Kane. Smart wrestling. He rolled back in. He stopped the referee's 10 count. Jericho now seems to be building the confidence that he has found that weakness, or he's created the weakness on Kane's knee.
Look at those big freaky legs.
Kane stretches out halfway to the ring. Look at this.
Oh my God. Yeah, this will do it.
This is the shades of another great Canadian. Chris the Hitman Hart with a figure four leg lock wrapped around the ring post.
And listen, can you hear Kane? Can you hear Kane actually screaming? Was the referee screaming at Chris Jericho too? But
I'll tell you what, it would be a damn shame if Kane loses this match or wins it by count out or disqualification.
What do you want out of this guy? I mean, what, you want him to be greedy? He's already a tag team champion. Well, you want him to have everything?
There ain't very many folks that have gone in the record books being a tag champion and an intercontinental champion at the same time, or simultaneously, if you will.
That'd be freakish. Oh, lifting, come on!
Jericho got to go back to those legs, and he's trying to suplex Kane.
Oh,
his counter!
Oh my gosh,
what a power!
He could have landed right on his head, thank God he...
The challenger
really saved himself.
For the Intercontinental title, just overpowered the champion. Folks are going to stay with this match as long as it takes. This match is one fall to a finish. We've taken all our commercial breaks. We're not going anywhere.
No halftime either. Did I mention that?
Yeah, three or four times. Got a shot to the head by Kane. Kane visibly hurting on that leg, but
I don't even see how he's able to walk or stand.
And Kane's life has been full of challenges and pain. He's overcome them all, but can he overcome Jericho? And again, Jericho with that drop kick right on the patella. That kneecap taking a pounding, and Jericho again focusing on the leg.
I just don't feel that Kane deserves to be the champion.
What the hell are you talking about now? Where are you going with that?
What do you mean?
What is your point?
My point is, what, I mean, look at him.
Kane, if Kane wins this match tonight, he'll have two championship belts.
You're telling me he's gonna be world champion tonight?
He's gonna be Intercontinental champion. He wins this match,
and then world champion next. You just want Kane to be everything. Tag team champion, Intercontinental champion, and then world champion.
That's the way it's playing out. He'll never be women's champion. How's that? How's that for a compromise? And look at Kane fighting back. Big time right hands. Sends Jericho for the ride. Can't connect on the foot of Jericho. Well, with a top block.
Let me just say this, just for the record. We never want a man that wears a mask to be the world champion.
And why would that be? Why would that be? 8x10s don't look good. You ain't got a clue. This is what, listen to you sometimes, it's worse than watching Celebrity Boot Camp.
What?
Kane, the suplex.
Nothing's worse than watching Celebrity Boot Camp.
Kane dropping it all south on Chris Jericho. Kane has fought through Ric Flair's interference. Jericho's attack on his knee. Working, wrestling a full-time tag team schedule. This is all of his dates in the future were booked that way, and this may change his whole career.
Can you imagine that being our world champion? He can't even walk into 7-Eleven.
Well,
yeah, not with a mask on.
He might want to walk in there and buy some stacker too. I don't know what he wants. Kane with a right hand, a hard knockdown. And what, Kane's vertical. He is an animal. And Jericho's got to go back to that leg.
Back to that leg. Oh, no. Oh.
Jericho likes to use the walls in Jericho. He gets a chance on Kane. That's exactly what he's going to do. And he can continue to weaken that knee.
He gets thrown up. He higher in the air by Kane like that. He won't be. Oh, look out. No, this is real bad.
Another kill-the-world slam. Kane hooking that leg. Jericho. Oh, he had that. Almost hit that right shoulder uncovered. Kane covered Kane or Jericho the best he could. But the right shoulder wasn't covered up. Jericho scooted it off the canvas.
I don't know what you're worried about. I already told you Kane can't win this thing. He can try all he wants to. Oh,
shot that one. Jericho. Tuck and Joe. Oh, my God. Right on the top of the ring post.
How about a count out? He'll save the title.
And you know what surprised me a damn bit? If Jericho is going to lay there and get counted out, and maybe Kane's thinking the same thing.
Maybe Jericho's hurt. Maybe he's just smart.
Intercontinental Champion and the steel ring steps.
That could break a shoulder.
Guess who hurts the most? Kane limping.
No shoulder pads on Raw.
And this ain't no Raw roulette. This is for the Intercontinental title. Straight up.
Oh, but what about Raw roulette?
Every match next week will be determined by the spin of the wheel.
In Las Vegas. That'd be great.
First off, who do you think he is? Wink Martindale? Is he still alive?
Who?
Never mind.
Bischoff's alive and well.
Kane gonna take a chance here, and he connects with a clothesline up the top. There's a covering. It's gonna be, it should be over here. He's got three. Oh, come on. Woo. That was a little too damn close for
me. Hey,
wait a damn minute.
What?
There's the world's Triple H champion. Now, what's he doing here? Just saying hello?
Well, he didn't get a chance to let us know what he was doing. He was attacked. He was attacked by Kane.
He could have had his championship ass on the apron. Look at that, Kane, the Lion's Heart.
Wait, he got caught.
Jericho got caught for the throw. And Jericho.
Look at that.
Counter to touchland.
I told you.
Jericho counter to touchland after the Triple H's his distraction. And so Jericho going for the walls of Jericho on that injured leg of Kane with the world champion on the outside.
Blasted down by Kane.
Yeah, what a shot that was. Look at the low bridge. Look at the game. The Triple H don't want no part of Kane and no mercy. Oh, my. A belly-to-belly suplex outside. Kane with one bad leg now trying to fight two champions.
Triple H had to help Kane back into the ring.
Triple H looked like a desperate man to me. There's no way that the game wants any part of Kane. And no mercy or anywhere else. And Jericho, go for that missile drop kick. And he got it. This should be all here. Jericho, and Kane got his shoulder up. The Big Red Machine, that engine is still running.
Jericho.
Triple H has got the referee distracted. Jericho can't be.
Oh,
straight up, he's going to use a chair on him in the game. This is collusion. There's no doubt in my mind that Jericho and the game have gone into business together, at least for this one match on this one night.
It is Houston. It's Enron all over again. Shady Bendania.
Oh, the walls of Jericho.
Told you.
Kane fought his ass off, and us had a fight through two champs.
When are you going to listen to me? He tapped right there. I saw him. He tapped.
Kane never tapped. He's not gonna tap.
He will tap.
Kane, he's reaching.
Everybody
and
tap.
He got the rope. He got the rope, broke the hole. Somehow, Kane gutted it out. When you're almost 7 feet tall, you ain't gotta get that close. Keep your hand on the rope. And now look at Jericho going right back on
that. Oh, what about getting your hand on the throat?
Kane had a hand on that throat.
Yeah, but Kane's in a weakened condition now. Wait a minute.
Jericho can't win this match, and he knows it. He's going to try to get himself disqualified. That's all. Oh, Kane with a shot right back to the face. Jericho brought the chair in the ring just to get himself disqualified.
Disqualified Kane.
Oh, Kane looking at a choke slam. Jericho fought out of it. But wait a minute. Choke slam. Machine has become the Intercontinental Champion, and by God, Triple H cannot stand it.
I knew this was going to happen.
2 weeks in a row, the tag team title last week, the Intercontinental title this week, and will he be the world champion? No mercy. The game and Kane, and no mercy.